Last but certainly not least on the stream, Aaron Pasick. Aaron, you with us? You hanging? Let us know. We got another 5-star.
Yep, I'm here.
Profile? Uh-oh.
Oh, you said Aaron. My bad.
Oh, yeah. And I know you're here, man.
Is it?
Okay, we got the accolades, Ed. We got the accolades.
Sunshine State.
Class of 2022, two-time All-Area. Yeah. Two-time All-American Bowl selection, 1,000 all-purpose yards, 12 touchdowns, undefeated, 10-0 regular season. Let's go. Let's go. Hit the FIU.
In the playoffs, so.
Yep. Currently in the playoffs, so keep showing out. 330 squat, 265 bench press, and a 4.540. I see you. FIU virtual visit. Their coach was just hitting me up. He's loving what he's seeing, some of the guys coming through. We got a 10-minute highlight film. Aaron, we might be saying move this up, move that up. If you're hanging with us, we want to see 3 to 5 minutes of the best tape you got. 10 minutes is a long tape, but I'm excited to check it out. Still playing. Aaron Pasick, class of 2022.
Same here.
Starting out with teams. I like that. Oh, okay.
Absolutely.
Oh, okay. What opportunities we got, Aaron? Talk to us. 2022 and that late season push.
Start out the highlights with a bang.
Started out with a bang. Lemon Bay High School.
And, you know, the more things you get through, the more recruitable you'll make yourself. So you start out with the special teams.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes, sir.
Nice open field run running there after the catch.
Working back to your quarterback. This is exactly what you do in a scramble drill right here. You work to the sideline, back towards your quarterback. Yep. Great execution. And look at you, make it happen. Make it happen, Aaron. Good stuff.
And, you know, defensive backs tend to have problems with fast wide receivers, especially coming across the middle. And the quarterback puts it, in, you know, where the receiver can catch it in stride. And, you know, obviously the quarterback did it in that particular play, and Aaron did the rest. So, uh-oh.
Hey, I would move this up. This would be my first clip right here. I'll tell you. I already liked, obviously, you gave him the Louisiana Bayou, you know, on the little go ball here. Mm-hmm. But then, in addition to that, quarterback throws a nice little ball. You catch it, slip the two defenders, and then boom, right here. This is the part I like right here, Ed, is the final little move and acceleration coming out of it.
Yep. It's all about the speed, ooh, baby.
All about the speed.
That burst. We talk about a lot of skill players. That burst, when it stands out, it stands,
ooh,
out.
Hey, I might move this one up. No, actually, I don't know. I like the order. I like our order right now, Aaron. I'll be honest. I'm just saying this because I like these plays.
A lot of fire early.
That's what we want to see. And then you get this. Shoot. Ooh.
Boom. Skating out there.
Kickoff coverage. Big hit. Let's see you coming down on teams. Oh!
Oh! He's like, look, I'm not just a finesse guy. Look, boom. Hey, Aaron, let me know where you stand.
Yeah. Hey, be honest with you in the chat right here. You want to know what this tells me about Aaron that I like? Is that I guarantee you they put this squib kick in, you know, early in the week. They talked about that it was an opportunity, probably, unless they do this all the time. I don't know, Aaron, you let me know. But he was planning for this, Ed. He knew this was his play to go down and make a hit. And he showed out for it. Boom! Let's go. Let's go. And so that tells me he's smart. He's on teams. He's physical. You know, a lot of good things. Oh, wave to him. Wave to him, Aaron. Okay. Oh man, Aaron's got some swag to him too.
Lost him at the top of that route. Nice jab to the inside. Finished off the corner route. Great pass by the quarterback too. Uh-oh.
House call. House call. House call.
Hey, Joey, he could do it all.
Hey, we're seeing plays on plays on plays right now.
Got him with the hesitation.
The hezzy. Aaron, how many offers we got? Does Aaron have offers? Do we know? I got to check his Twitter. Yeah.
I was checking. I thought he might have had a couple. But I truly think he's definitely under the radar. For sure.
The Roll Scots. Okay, Monmouth. Just got an offer from Monmouth. Okay.
Oh, really? Okay. Up this way. Think.
Okay.
That might be another one.
Definitely under the radar. Ottawa football. NAIA, third most wins. See, hey, for Kenny, for Furman, for some of those guys that Jordan Schuler we highlighted. Now we're bringing you players now. This is definitely a guy you want to put on your radar. Definitely a guy that keep showing out, keep winning, some talented stuff.
Absolutely. Saw a lot there, a lot of explosive plays. And to me, anything over 20 plus yards, you know, that fits the bill. And definitely saw a lot of those type of plays. He has quickness off the line of scrimmage, gets separation in and out of his cuts, separation off the line of scrimmage, fluid routes. Physical, has that breakaway speed, so elusiveness as a runner, and you know he has that maybe deceptive strength that you know he has deceptive strength to shake off tackles once he catches the football, right? As you saw, you know, in the first couple of plays he made the catch and didn't go down easy. He took the contact and kept it moving for the touchdown. So I'm definitely impressed with Aaron. I don't say his last name on Pasick. And I think that's an athlete that should benefit. One, and we talked about this before, Joey, he's still playing in the playoffs, right? So that's extra games. That's extra eyes on him and his teammates and, you know, whoever else is playing in the playoffs right now. So best of luck to him and his teammates this weekend. And, you know, hopefully he continues to get more looks from college coaches because I think he's definitely talented enough to warrant those additional opportunities.
No doubt. We're doing our part, Aaron, as much as we can. I'll definitely be talking with some coaches that are hitting my line right now. Definitely, you know, do what I can, but love the tape, showing all things, punt returning, wide receiver, kickoff returner, dynamic player. So, really everybody today was came back in and popped it back off, you know, ran it back. It was a good tape mix of 2022 guys, 2023, 2024 with Jules, but overall all guys that should definitely be getting opportunities.
Absolutely. And the skill guys, you know, things that stood out. It's the speed and quickness and just the playmaking, you know, big playmaking ability of the skill players. And then you got the 2022 guys, Caden Stem and Jordan Schuler. I think Caden probably end up at the Division III level from what, you know, I know, which is, you know, be perfect for him. I think he'll fit into any scheme that, you know, ends up at. As a legit dual threat quarterback. And Jordan Schuler, you know, I knew a little bit, I knew about him before looking at his film, but after, you know, watching his tape a couple of times, including with you, I definitely came away more impressed and maybe a little surprised he doesn't have, you know, a few more FBS offers, but, you know, that, and that's not shading the offers he already has, but, you know, I think his talent level definitely warrants, you know, maybe a few more mid-major offers at the FBS level.